The brother of lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. makes good on his promise to personally attend the Senate probe into the Dagamo killing. Former Negros Oriental Governor Pride Henry Teves vows to cooperate in the investigation to clear his name after being implicated in the killing of his successor.
Doing my duty as a Filipino citizen that once called here and invited, I should be present and answer questions truthfully.
Philippine Interior Chief Benhur Abalos, meanwhile, assures Teves of his safety if he returns to the Philippines. His remarks come as Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva revealed. Some eyewitnesses confirmed to him Teves was recently spotted at a hotel in South Korea.
Ako mismo magbabantay, sir. I assure you 100%.
So kung mamatay siya, ikaw mo na nakot?
Yes, sir.
Oh, thank you. Usapang lalaki yan.
Ha? This to the killing on...
Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla, meanwhile, says the Philippine government may designate Teves as a terrorist. He says activities allegedly involving Teves are covered under the anti-terror law.
In this case, Mr. Chairman, the activities that led to this to the killing on March 4, all are covered under the anti-terror law. The recruitment, the financing, the purchase of firearms, the distribution of firearms. We are afraid right now that if we immediately file that under a terrorism case, based on the crimes that transpired, it may prejudice other convictions that can be secured easily with the same punishment for murder, for multiple murder, Mr. Chairman. However, as a solution to the impasse here about the surrender of Mr. Teves or Congressman Teves, we are looking at designating him or proscribing him as a terrorist, to have him proscribed by the Court of Appeals or designated by the Anti-Terror Council because of the acts that happened.
An emotional widow of Governor Degamo also attended the Senate inquiry. Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo thanks senators in helping her family in their quest for justice.
Gagawin ko po talaga lahat para pag nagharap kami ni Ruel, sasabihin ko po talaga sa kanya, Ruel, ginawa ko po talaga lahat ng kaya kong gawin sa ngalan ng hustisya para sa iyo. At kasama po dito ang aking hope and desire na sana po, with justice comes peace. Kailangan po talaga namin ang kapayapaan sa Negros Oriental.
The brother of lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. makes good on his promise to personally attend the Senate probe into the Dagamo killing. Former Negros Oriental Governor Pride Henry Teves vows to cooperate in the investigation to clear his name after being implicated in the killing of his successor.
Doing my duty as a Filipino citizen that once called here and invited, I should be present and answer questions truthfully.
The chief of the Metro Manila Police calls on former Prisons Bureau Chief Gerald Bantag and his former deputy Ricardo Zulueta to surrender to authorities. Last week, the Muntinlupa and Las Piñas Regional Trial Courts issued arrest warrants for the two in connection with the killings of journalist Percy Lapid and alleged middleman Jun Villamor. A massive manhunt is on for Bantag and Zulueta.
Ang mensahe ko naman para sa grupong ito, sana ay kusang loob na kayong sumuko bilang mga dating pagpatupad ng batas. Nalalaman ninyo kung ano ang tamang gawin. Huwag na sana ninyong pahirapan pa ang inyong kalagayan. Mas makakabuting harapin ninyo sa hukuman ang mga reklamong ibinibintang sa inyo. Makakaasa kayo na pangangalagaan ng NCRPO ang inyong karapatang pantao.
Meanwhile, the Metro Manila Police Chief hopes Joel Escorial, the self-confessed gunman in the Percy Lapid killing, will be placed under the Witness Protection Program.
Let's see po, because we need a very good witness dito. I think we are also amenable kung pwede saan maging may pasok sa Witness Protection Program. At DDOJ na po yan. Yes, to strengthen the case at mas maabot natin yung mga mastermind dito, that is possible that he will be also included as a witness in this case.